Baro experiment named SMILE2 using as a large electron tracking computon camera at the North Pole with a collaboration of the Swedish geophysicist. And so it's the main content of our talk is what can we do detect high Z and GRB in the future experiment. If we have time, I also mention about the terrestrial gamma ray burst occurs in the North Pole or South Pole. It's quite also interesting for the particle acceleration. I don't need to explain here. Horizon such as MEV gamma ray astronomy has been delayed. It is quite simple. And the MEV region is usually quite suffer from the huge backgrounds. It's a famous spectrum, the top spectrum obtained from computer. As it's here, there are many backgrounds come as the albedo or the detectors itself. Like this, it's a only background, the signal is quite small. Therefore, key important computer detected is about 30 celestial objects. But it's mainly due to the computer had so independent background detection tools using a top upper detector, between upper detector and lower detectors. Therefore, they could remove the almost background and they could detect the celestial object. Therefore, key point in this field is how to realize a good background detection method. As indicated here, in these three orders wide band energy region, they are still unexplored. But there are many good targets, nucleosynthesis, or some black holes, or neutron stars, or the particle accelerations, also gamma ray burst. Next, I briefly mentioned about the principle of our electron computing camera. We use the gas detector as a computon scattering material. It quite looks crazy because gas is quite rare to the gamma ray. But key point is in the MEV regions, as mentioned before, how to detect the background is most important thing. By detecting the direction of the recoil electron, it's quite powerful to reject the background. One is we can reconstruct, limit the direction of gamma ray. Usually, computon camera provide only direction of the incident gamma ray at the circles, not the point. But by detecting a direction of electrons, we can obtain such an arc, like an arc. Also, using this additional angle, we can try a kinematical fitting, event by event. It's quite important. Also, we measure the energy deposit in that electron distracts, we can also easily carry out the particle ID identification in a TPC. Also, another key point is that gas and scintillator are quite so cheap. Therefore, not cheap in scintillator, but it's quite easy to increase the size of detector. Also, compared to semiconductor type computon camera, scintillator's efficiency is quite good for the stopping power. Therefore, usually efficiency of computon camera is obtained in the multiplication of the forward detector and the backward detector. Therefore, even use of the even in the gas, but we use quite good stopping power scintillators at this time. So efficiency is not so different from the semiconductor detectors. So it's original, so it's quite data, not simulations. For the two identical energy sources, we can easily separate in such a small event. If we don't use the SPD angles, it's a separation quite bad. Also, by applying a kinematical cut, almost all background can be removed without the energy information. But gas stopping power is not so bad for the computon scattering. It's if we use the about thickness about 50 centimeters and 2 times the atmosphere, originally computon scattering probability near the 10%. Therefore, 1% level systematic system efficiency or the Compton scattering is not so impossible. It's also if we detect this 0.5 efficiency detector size is 50 cm³ use a xenon or CFO gas 2 times the atmosphere electron track camera will so provide about such a level effective area. It has similar level of Comptons, but field of view is quite large, and so this ETC provides so particular identifications over the good direction and kinematical fitting. To realize such a good electron tracking devices, we developed such a micro pattern detectors. It's quite originally developed by Kyoto Group. Key point is this micropixel counter with a MuPic was made using a printed board technology. So it's a quite cheap and easily we can get a large detector. Now, Japanese company provide this detector about 10 centimeter squares, 20 centimeter squares, 30 centimeter squares. It's a commercially you can get. Also, it's quite simple. You can attach some connectors in the vessels. It's a connector board and attach some amplifier, you can get the signal like this. Also, surrounding pixel scintillator counters, we can reconstruct a gamma ray image like this. Also, we can already reconstruct such a very complex images. Key point is that quite common imaging test was a medical use because corner part is a visible or not. It's quite important. Well, it's a test of the spectra. Also, we use the gem to some sort of support of the gains because our sampling pitch is 400 megahertz, too small. Therefore, in each pixel, only so 2 over 4 electrons come. Therefore, by combining gains, gem gains up 10, and so MuPic provides about 7,000. Therefore, totally we obtained quite high gains. Also, gem is a quite good tool for suppress the feedback ions. Also, we tested several type of crystals, GSO, and so lanthanum bromide. Lanthanum bromide is quite good energy resolution, is about 3% in about cesium gamma ray at 600 kV regions. And so obtained angular resolution about 4 degrees. So lanthanum bromide. But for the use of the balloon experiment, we use a GSO. It's a quite little bit cheap, and we can construct a large detectors. But angular resolution is about 6 degrees.
Just a moment. Is this for what instrument? 4 degrees, I mean.
Gas detector combined with lanthanum bromide detector.
And what
angular resolution is an arm resolution. Mm. Usually, Compton evaluation was angular resolution, we use the arm. Also, this detector can provide us SPD resolution. At that time, it's quite bad. More than near the 100 degrees. But it's quite useful or like this. It's a SPD resolution, only about 100. But combined the several gamma rays, only 5 gamma rays, we can clearly identify the point source. So also we calculate if we calculate the energy position, angular resolution from the energy resolutions, expected energy resolution is about 2.7 degrees, but obtained resolution is this resolution. Main reason is point is the uncertainty of the Compton point.
And what about the systematic?
Yeah, like a systematic. It's a as mentioned, it's a quite difficult to reconstruct a Compton point because in such a low energy electron track, these are scattered. Also, sampling is too small. Therefore, sampling rate is not so good at that time. If we improve the resolution near the 1 millimeter, we obtain such a good energy resolution. This resolution, it's a quite similar level in also IDR, so semiconductor Compton telescope. In parallel, we also developed the medical use camera. It's quite so good training for the imaging because all times imaging have to be compared with a PET image. They are quite good for the so polish up the so imaging power. It's obtained so our camera. It's a rabbit and we used some medical medicine to concentrate the heart. Clearly we can obtain the heart on the thyroid gland. Also it's a quite so impressive image of a molecular image. Therefore it's a quite high energy image. It's a maybe quite unique image obtained by the Compton camera.
What it was
image?
Was it frog?
It's a mouse. Mouse. It's a quite easy. It's a bladder and livers. It's a metal. Metal usually so concentrate the livers and so bladders. And so muscles. Therefore, it's not so smearing. It's quite important. It's we can clearly show the small bladder. Also, until now, we tried quite so many RIs useful in so medical molecular bioimaging. Now, we skip in the detail. It's also Compton camera for the use of the medical is the main target is the imaging of the for the so beam therapy. Because so usually so PET cannot use such a purpose. Because expected positron gamma ray emission is quite broad, like this. Only so prompt gamma ray from nuclei is indicated a strong correlation in the so black peak. But it's only simulation. Therefore, we try to it. It's the first data in the world obtained in an actual so beam experiment. Clearly, annihilation gamma ray distributed. It's a so water target. Water is quite so similar to the body. Also, it's a continuum images for the high energy gamma rays, clearly concentrated black peak position. Also, simulation and real data, it's quite consistent. Key point is that it's a quite good simulation for the continuum observation in the universe because proton, high energy proton hits, therefore many background comes. Neutron, including neutron, many neutron comes, but we have a no shield. It's clearly easy to separate the neutron in particular. So next, I talk about the SMILE experiment. SMILE experiment is a for the test balloon experiment to reveal the so ability to ETCC for the astrophysical use. Already we carried out the first experiment about 6 years ago. It's a quite small ETC was launched from the Japan site, about only 10 centimeter cube detectors. But so in so 3 hours observation, we obtained about so 100,000 events. But we can select only so 900 gamma ray events. And downward, and we can separate down going and up going. Down going comes from the tops. Therefore, it's quite consistent in the simulations. It's also, as indicated here, dramatically two orders background can easily remove. Also, obtain the diffuse cosmic ray and atmospheric gamma ray spectrum. Quite consistent previous data. It's also obtained, so it's a in the TPC's energy deposit and the track length. Clearly, it's a so laboratory measurement, and it's a so flight measurement. In a flight, there are many so particles comes. because we have no bed counter. Only scintillator counter is the top and the bottom. They are, but not covered all regions. There are many minimum energy particle counts, and so we can select here. Also, neutron is located in this region. Also, we observed more than 1,000 neutron events. Also, it's quite useful for the atmospheric neutron background if we, for the satellite experiment. It also obtained the dependence of gamma ray flux on the atmospheric depths. It's quite consistent in the data. Also, therefore, this ETCC detected the Oort event. You know, 80% is gamma rays from outside of the detectors. Only detector background is only 20%. Recently, Berkeley NCT experiment provide good data. It's the first maybe data indicator, so catching club signals using advanced computon camera. But they use the quite heavy beta counters in the VZO. Also, they remain the match event about so 290 kilo event background after the so data cutting. Also, they detected about 600 club gamma, but in the background in this region, more than so 29,000 event remained as a background. If we develop a computon camera used in a satellite, we have to reduce a background. Such a background is quite difficult to detect a weak wave gamma source. To push the ETCC experiment to identify that each so celestial object, now we have a plan to a long duration flight from the Kiruna, Kiruna and around the North Pole. With the collaborators, in almost is a geophysicist. Because in the North Pole, particular acceleration, electron accelerator usually so radiation belt to up to a 10 MeV level. It's quite surprising for me. It's such a high energy electron precipitate in both poles like this, and it penetrates about 50 kilometer altitude. It's quite important because this region is a ozone generation region. Therefore, now so it's some key factor for the ozone problems. There were recently many geophysicists have a strong interest in this region. Therefore, we provide the using the ETCC the amazing such a precipitations. A collaboration with the satellite. It's a Japanese satellite we launched 2015 to measure the plasma condition in the radiation belt. It's quite good to understanding particle acceleration to the relativistic regions because this satellite measures the plasma conditions, including magnetic field or plasma densities, and so distribution of the particle in the plasma. Also, we can measure the finally accelerated particles in this region. Now, to push this program, we now so constructing a flight model. TPCC size is quite big, about 30 centimeter cube TPC and surrounded so DSO scintillator. It's now we construct flight model. By constructing such a medium type ETCC, we expect about at least 50 times increase effective area compared to SMILE 1. But so still SMILE effective area is too small, point only 5 centimeters. But at the Japan side, we use the SMILE 1 background data. Using this data, only so 3 hours observation, we are expected to detect about 5 sigma or more than signals. Key point is that this background is a real data, not so simulations. Also, we studied the details of the SmileOne performance. Also, if we realize such a detectors, ideally we obtained about so 0.2 or 0.3 efficiency in a, so in a sub-MEB regions. But obtained efficiency is quite low, two orders are low. It's a many leads. But so by surrounding more scintillators and also increasing gas pressures, we covered in this region. But still one order now so difference exists in a so ideal case. It is a quite simple. It's a quite difficult to identify the so electrons. To therefore, if we improve the, so electron tracking or electron detection efficiency, it's a efficiency dramatically improved. So it's a, so now the electron if four times it's a also such a tracking improvement also improve the angular resolutions. It's quite in particular SPD is quite important to reduce the backgrounds. So now it's a I skip the reason, the detail, but now by new method, it's quite simple. In the previous case, automatically we take a X and Y strip signal coincidence takes only 10 nanogate second. It's a too short. But so now we take a coincidence by software. In that case, we select in such a so. Changes. For example, it's a so muon tracks, but so data, it's a data distribution, old and new. Data is quite so increased about so five times. Also, it's a previous electron tracks. This is about so 7 meters, but so sampling is 400 micron, but it's attained only so 20 level. It's quite small, but it's a new method. Like a lines, but also we add this another information. It's a pulse width. It's a quite a pulse width in the so related so pulse height. Therefore, these part in the clearest we can detect the black peak region. It's a stopping part. Also, it's a so scattering part. It's a quite easy to identify the scattering point. Also, it's a so also X-ray image only 30 KeV. In it's a 5 millimeter level, but in this side about 20 hit exist. Therefore, indicated here as about so 30 KeV X-rays. Perfectly, we can identify the direction for all electrons. It's a minimum is about 5 hit, and peaks are more than 20 hit. Therefore, TPC, it's a so independent, it's a quite good so polarimeter, maybe. Because the TPC covers all directions. Therefore, we developed the independent triggers, so Compton trigger or TPC trigger. It's a quite good measurement of the X-ray polarization. Also, it's a Compton event. Still, imaging this is now ongoing. Tomorrow, today's morning, I got the new data. Finally, I present some data about the imaging. But indicating here, yeah, it's a tracking and so track length. Clearly, we can identify the electron track more clearly. We can clearly separate the contained event and so penetrating event. Also, it's a new tracking. It's a red indicator, so old tracking. Therefore, in this case, it's a scattering point. Clearly scattering point is a misidentified. Therefore, in the previous data, such an event is a exists maybe so many events in such a type. Therefore, maybe more than 10 times efficiency would be improved. Now we are testing. Therefore, soon we present a new result. Also, by using also SPD information, it's quite use for the imaging. It's also usually it's a so simple way to the so conventional Compton. It's a Compton telescope have to be so convoluted, so circles positions. Therefore, it's a background. Background also by the acceptance peak shows some peaks. Also, it's a point source, but also such a broad tail exists. It's quite important because it's a no background. But so usually there are many backgrounds so overlaid this series. If we use only so 8 degrees SPD, quite different. More than five times so improved significance. Also, therefore usually we apply the so maximum likelihood expectation maximization to obtain only arm resolutions. For the no background, even in a conventional method, it's quite useful. But apply the sub, if background overlaid, it's quite difficult to apply this method. But so our ETC has a demerit because so higher gamma rays electron penetrator detector to cover the such a effect. Now we now so challenged by the simulation. In a so put the such a thin plastic scintillator wall set inside the detector. In that case, we cover the about so 10 eV regions. Like this. Therefore, in a so we want to continue the balloon experiment about 5 years. It's a because it's a about so solar maximum period. And so maybe 3 years later, we put such a scintillator, maybe cover the quite wide range. Also, we improve the so electron tracking method. Sensitivity is improved about, it's a two ideal, maybe this line, these lines. Next, I will talk about the so ETCC, whether it is useful for the GRB detections. It's a so scatter plot is a so time duration and fluence in obtained so Swift data. It's a red character indicator Z. Clearly, it's a high Z concentrator, so shorter time duration regions. But so considering a so time dilation, these events are extended, have to be extended this region. Therefore, it's a obviously affected by the maybe so trigger some bias something. It's a quite so simple so some considerations for the such a peak sensing type detectors. Usually in a for the higher the gamma ray burst, red shift effect and so dilation effect affected like this. Also area such a area detector also noise level is usually so photon sensitive limit usually proportional to square of the areas. Considering these data, it's a quite simple estimation. It's a, such a z that's so proportional only so one fourth of the area size. Therefore, it's a swift, it's a seven, it's about 10 times area detector of swift, only so 12 or 20 level, 12 level. It's a, this data is quite consistent in this, this so more detailed so studies. This is quite simple, for the, because for the higher gamma ray burst with a high Z, is that so? I'm sorry. If we cancel it, we accumulate the so long time for the event, we can cancel it the so dilation effect. Therefore, if we such an integrated trigger realize, sensitivity is dramatically improved. But so it's quite difficult for the coded mask. But if we realize the so real imaging, like X-ray telescopes or optical telescopes, it's quite easy. So as a, only so, but so usually so such a telescope in the field is quite small. But so if we realize the ideal Compton camera, it's maybe so possible. Also energy region, it's also extra photon distributions. As indicated here, higher energy region, quite so low background region. Also low energy region also looks so low background, but in this region, so huge so thermal X-ray comes from the usual stars. Therefore, it's a quite difficult region to trigger other gamma rays burst. But so also gamma ray flux shifted. Maybe so peak shift, maybe so between the 10 and so 100 kV region. But usually, longer tail exists or the most of gamma ray burst. Therefore, even if gamma ray with so Z is 20, it's a tail extended, is expected to extend to at least the MEV regions. Therefore, about so 50 kV to MEV kV, it's a maybe possible region to detect the imaging trigger for the gamma ray burst. If it's a so quite simple reason to Hawaii to reduce the background, usually it's a so coded masks. It's a imaging shift in all regions. It's a so in the case of shift in a 60 degree. Therefore, accumulated in this region background. But it's a real imaging where field of view about so three Sterlajian case, and so we select reduce about divide so 10 degree regions. We can trigger in each region. Their background dramatically reduces. Also in this region, also we have to reject the background from the satellite. It's a quite important in the online level. Therefore, our ETC is a maybe so unique method to such a good so background rejections. Also, therefore, now we consider the about 100 square centimeter area detector. It's quite ideal case in the so Compton, now so level of so Compton detector. But as indicated here, not so impossible level. Also now, background region is a 4 degree we consider. In that case, as it indicated here, also we have to consider the so point accuracy of gamma ray burst. Because resolution of the one gamma in the Compton is not so good. Only 1 degree or 2 degree. It's quite inefficient for the so optical telescopes. But by accumulating the 700 gamma rays, point accuracy is easily improved about this level. Therefore, at least 100 gamma rays are detected, have to be detected. It's a base of the considerations. Therefore, if we realize that so 100 square meter electron tracking Compton camera, as indicated here, it's maybe so this energy is it's a typical gamma ray burst, and this gamma ray set that so z equal 20 is expected photon is about so 100 thousands of photons, more than so 100 kb. In such a case, almost gamma ray was detected in such a by such a big ATCC. Also, it's a Dr. Yonetok calculated in a so present gamma ray burst. If present gamma ray burst moved to a high z equal 20, it's a expected flux in a so this energy regions. We move to a MEV regions and wide, and so we calculate the number. It's a quite so enough number to detect such a gamma ray burst. Also, we use the so Fermi data. It's a famous gamma ray burst. Also, it's a consistent. If 100 square centimeter ETC, the size is about 1 meter, 50 meter detectors surrounding some scintillators. In that so low energy region, less than 1 MeV about 100 square meter possible. If we use some xenon 1CFO gas, maybe so two times the atmosphere level. Also now we consider some short and small type detector. It's only 40 centimeters cube ETCC. It's a detection area about 10 square meters. Also it's quite enough. About so, this is a xenon case in an argon case. Key point is that if such a detector concentrates, so gamma ray burst searching in argon detector is quite good because even in so 70 or 80 kV gamma ray also detect. Therefore, in a low energy region, quite good efficiency. In the xenon detector, it's a self-absorption occurs. Therefore, in a low energy region, the efficiency degrees. So recently, so some theorists now propose that population 3 gamma ray burst, its mass is so quite large near the solar, about so thousands times of solar mass. In that case, quite so big gamma ray burst are expected. But key point is that its duration is quite long, about so, I'm sorry, it's 10 to 5 seconds. 10 to 5 seconds. Therefore, it's maybe 1 day. Therefore, sensitivity, flux in each per second is quite low, less than 10 minus 8. In such a case, we calculate using a 40 centimeter cubes or small type detectors. Quite so, integration time is after 1,000 time, detected about so 100 gamma rays, it's a quite sensitivity about so near the 10 sigma level. If we accumulate the so long times, it's a quite good so sensitivity. But too much is 900 too big. Therefore, minimum detection is about so here indicates in the 5 sigma detection, the 10 to 5 seconds is about so 100 gamma rays. In that case, about so 100, less than 100, so smaller size population series size also okay. Therefore, maybe so such a detector covers any so long duration gamma ray burst. Key point is it's a so time distributions now present. No, it's maybe like this. It's quite a little bit old. If we detected the new generation in the so long gamma ray burst, it's a quite so good evidence for the so population 3 generation. We need only so 5 or 6 events concentrated more than for 1,000 seconds. It's a quite different type of gamma ray exist. Also, it's associated with no galaxies or the quite faint galaxy. It's a quite robust proof to existing so population 3. It's quite important is a gamma ray detector is the main detector to catch the population 3 stars. Because even in the so 30 meter telescope, it's quite difficult to catch the so population 3 star itself. Only such a big telescope could detect only so galaxies expected including such a population 3 stars. But so gamma ray detector, gamma ray imagers, if we detect such a long gamma ray burst generation, it's a clearly identification in a population 3. I think it's a only unique method not present. Now so human being can detect population 3. Also, as you know, gas detected quite good trackers are charged particles. Already we measured so, such a E plus E minus resolutions. It's a maybe world best record in the less than 20 MeVs. Still, reconstruction is perfect. Key point is opening, we cannot measure the small opening angles. Therefore, angular resolution restricted this limit the opening angles. If we measure the, it's due to the so trigger scintillators because we have to make a hole to escape the direct beams. Therefore, if we can reduce such an opening angle limitation, it obtain the angular deselection. This also we can measure the energy to each electrons. It's a limited angular deselection. Therefore, maybe this level is possible. Also, it's quite important to push the high energy astrophysics because in a 70 MeV, it's also pi zero peak exists. It's quite important for the particular action mechanism in the for supernova remnant pulsars. Finally, I briefly mentioned about the gamma ray burst in the North Pole. It's a first observed so terrestrial gamma ray burst due to the electron relative precipitation in the kiln. It's a background level. It's a quite strong gamma ray burst. This spectrum extended to 10 MeV. It's extended about so 20 minutes. It's a particle. It's a so magnetic field atoms around the Earth. Particle concentrated in the magnetic field and sometimes precipitated in these regions. Therefore, we can measure the many parameters here, also here. It's quite important to understand the mechanism of particle acceleration because in astrophysics, there are never, it's quite difficult to obtain such a pitch angles or the magnetic field direction, this such thing, it's like never so we measure such a details. But in even only so in around the so Earth we can measure. Therefore, it's quite also important to resolve the details of the particle acceleration. Also, it's also penetration depths in atmospheres. It's electrons. In a, so such a MeV region, MeV electron only can penetrate in the ozone region. Therefore, it's quite now expected to affect the generation of the ozone. Also, it's another type of the so, terrestrial gamma ray burst. It's a quite micro burst. It's each peak is so about so less than seconds. Key point is that it's so same point occurs over many points. Like a so rain occurs. It's a, until now, there are no imaging observations. There, it's a temporal or the positional, the still so unknown. It's a quite important information. But so by imaging, it will be cleared. There are many physics also exist. So finally, a key point is that now improvement tracking performance will increase the sensitivity of SMILES dramatically. Such an improvement, maybe so, I think so, satellite type have a so much near the so 100 square effective area would be possible in the present technology. Also, in the balloon experiment, if we can carry out a 2 weeks duration long flight, in such a case, gamma ray burst occurs about so near the 10. Also, we carried out so several years. Therefore, maybe 10 gamma ray bursts in the field of view is occurs. Therefore, we may check the some so identification of gamma ray burst by ETCC. So finally, I present several slides obtained today's morning, sent by my students. This is also obtained tracks. It's also first experiment. Therefore, still we cannot so reconstruct the detail. Only so connection in the line, only this thing. Therefore, but so key point is that scintillator here, time projection here, and it's identified directions, not circles. It's quite so close. Also close. Some event is maybe it's a so SPD effect. Also, clearly, we can separate the so, stopping electron. Also, key point is it's a quite rough data. Electron only so we cut the so electron contained in the TPC. It's a Compton trajectory. It's a energies and so Compton angles. This is the Compton event part. Also, these are the expected directions and obtained directions. It's a clearly correlation. Also applies only energy cut we can remain the only applies the so ddx cut. Clearly we obtain the so Compton event like this. Even at the fiducial level we can clearly peak. We need more detailed analysis. Also, it's a only simple back projections using the ARMS SPD. We have a usually we apply the some sort of probability method, but it's only so plot the ARMS and the SPD. But clearly, we obtain the peaks in the 10 degree regions. It's maybe it's this uncertainty that maybe due to the so SPD resolution. It indicates the SPD resolution about 20 degrees more good, better. It's a quite improvement because until now, resolution only 100. Therefore, it's a quite improvement for the Compton camera because it's a no background. That's all. Thank you.